it was a lovely day, and I watched it and I just thought, wow, I want to do television. I want to get into television, because if that's been made and put out, there's nothing to beat. And it's probably the greatest influence in my life.
And so in 1998, T4 was on its way with its first ever presenters. Everyone was so excited.
My gut feeling working on T4 was, this ain't gonna last.
My best memory of T4, I can still vividly remember the first show. I was so excited to have Eagle Eye Cherry on, because he was so huge at the time. And then I think the next week, we had the Cheeky Girls, or something like that, and there was that brilliant contrast.
This is a fact, it's about first times, Ben. I remember the first time I went on holiday. I found a piece of American ship.
T4 was soon changing the face of telly like an LA surgeon changing the face of people's faces. Except in a good way, and not a weird, stretched lizard face kind of way. Cool, huh? Well, no.
I don't quite know how you can even remain vaguely cool and link into the Waltons, though. I certainly wasn't. It wasn't. It was very difficult on a Sunday morning.
T4 was hot.
Breasts this big. Yeah.
But with the introduction of some new blood, the T4 oven really got cooking.
Well, thanks to Dermot and Margarita, T4's viewing figures just leapt. And I'm going to have to get technical here, but they leapt by about this much.
Dermot and Margarita, they were definitely my favourites.
Margarita and Dermot, easily.
Definitely Margarita and Dermot.
And I mean, that might not seem much to you, but I mean, in TV terms, that is huge.
We were both so incredibly nervous to the point where I would throw up about 5 minutes before we went on air every morning.
Absolute cinch, easiest piece of television I've ever done.
Absolutely.
The real world of television, I ask you.
Dermot and I had a great time working together. Loved it. Those weekends were a real blast. So wouldn't change a minute of it for the world.
Dermot, that's fantastic. You've got that apple pie, because we're about to show the trailer for American Pie 2 after the break.
Are we?
Yeah, it looks well tasty. Do you mind if I have a nibble?
I probably left a bit prematurely, if I'm honest with you, and it's probably one of the only regrets I have, is I reckon I could have stayed there another year and had fun for another year. I still miss it a little bit, but I really missed it for a while.
And so, with Dermot and Margarita gone, it was time for new livestock to enter the T4 barn. A 6'4" dazzling hunk of a man mountain who would one day become the shiny-toothed white knight saviour of British Saturday night television. And June Sarpong.
With all she offers me protection, a love and affection, whether I'm right or wrong, and I'm usually right.
Welcome to Celebrity Porn. That's P-A-W-N, not the mucky stuff. Oh no, if you want some of that, go down to Blue Rupert's in Bethnal Green.
Ooh. This new dream team was soon stamping its face all over T4, even impressing the unimpressible.
You are, without question, the most original talent in this country.
Is it June who was singing with Tom Jones?
Yeah.
I thought that was amazing. Sex bomb,
sex bomb. Oh my God, that woman's got an awful voice, but a wonderful pair of lips.
I had such a great run. I loved all the interviews I did. I loved the show. I actually would not do anything differently.
I'm sure June would have made a great replacement as Prime Minister. But then she's still got so much to give Youth Entertainment TV.
I was so nervous the first time I was interviewed by June. To sit there plugging my little album with someone with such immense talent, I felt like a fraud.
I'm very proud of everything that we achieved on T4 and the fact that its legacy continues. It's 10 years now, and it's still as good as it was, and that's what makes me so proud of it, and it was difficult to leave because, you know, I loved it so much.
June and Vern were an unstoppable TV juggernaut, battering viewers into submission with their awesome skills. But with the bombshell that they were moving on, T4 was rocked to its very core. Would it survive without them? Find out later on T4 The History.
Okay, Tony Blair has never in his life said the word TV before.
This is a great way to celebrate 10 years of T4. If you want to see more highlights from T4's first 10 years, then go to channel4.com/T4S10.
Yeah, but keep watching, because directly after Frock Me, we're going to be unleashing Showstopper 4 in our countdown of unforgettable scenes from T4's show archive. And we got a special performance from the Sugar Babes and a very explosive Orange Unsigned act.
Just realised the tune that's playing in the background.
Nothing wrong with that.
Right now, Hollywood beauty Eva Mendes is in Frock Me.
Eva's actually a very generous woman. She heard it was T4's 10th birthday and insisted, actually she begged, that it was a birthday suit special.
Is that really necessary? No.